James Webb is currently undergoing a cryogenic vacuum test in a very large chamber called Chamber A at NASA Johnson Space Center. And the purpose of this test is to make sure that all the components of the telescope are going to function in the cold vacuum environment of space. I'm a coatings engineer and I'm working very closely with the James Webb contamination control team.
Before we start the cryogenic test, the contamination control team works to clean the inside of the chamber so that Webb can stay as contamination-free as possible. It's not possible for anyone to access the chamber during the test, so we have to do all our contamination mitigation before the test starts.
And my job specifically involves the development and testing of a new NASA coatings technology that can help mitigate molecular contamination concerns.
So the plenum is an area at the bottom of Chamber A. It's the space that's directly below where Webb sits, ready for testing. To get to the plenum, we need to carefully walk in the space between the helium shroud, which is surrounding Webb, and the outer wall of Chamber A. There's no light, so we have to wear headlamps. The plenum is considered a confined space because there's only one way in and only one way out. We have to wear oxygen sensors to make sure that it's safe to be down there. We have to take a ladder down to the plenum. That's the lowest level at the bottom of the chamber. And the floor, it's actually the curved bottom of Chamber A.
So there are molecular contaminants that exist in the plenum. For example, you have your hydrocarbons, your silicones, and these are sometimes very difficult to remove almost completely. And the contamination team they've done an amazing job of reducing the existing levels down to a very minimal amount. And it's this residual contaminants that can potentially outgas during vacuum testing, spread throughout the chamber, and perhaps even deposit on a very cold, sensitive surface, such as James Webb. So it's very important to tackle the problem at the source, and that's why we've placed the max samples in the plenum area. We do a thorough analysis on the types of contaminants that were collected and how much. That data is very useful and it shows that we are protecting James Webb from molecular contamination. I've devoted a lot of my early career developing and testing this coating, and I'm really happy to see it being used on a lot of flight projects.